Dan Hooker and Paul Felder went to war for 5 rounds. It was a very close and competitive fight, so it was no surprise that it was a split decision. One judge gave 3 rounds to Felder, but the other 2 judges gave 3 rounds to Hooker, so he gets the split decision victory. He'd like to take on Justin Gaethje next. Felder says this could be his final fight in mixed martial arts. Jimmy Crute kept dragging Mihail Olaszczyk to the mat and ended up getting the top via Kimura 3-29 into the first round. Crute is now 11-1, and 8 of those 11 victories are by stoppage. Yao Xiaonan wins a dominant unanimous decision over Karolina Kowalkiewicz. 30-26 on all the scorecards. Yan's undefeated in her last 11 fights. Karolina has lost 4 in a row. Ben Sosley has a good chin and took a lot of shots from Marcus Ejirio de Lima, but a clubbing right hand put him away 1-28 into the fight. Lima has 13 first round finishes. In front of his hometown fans, Brad Riddell picks up a split decision victory over Magomed Mustafayev. Riddell says he wants to take on Alexander Hernandez next. After dropping Kevin Aguilar with a left hook, Zubera Tsukagov poured on the pressure to get the TKO victory 3-20 into the fight. He'd like to take on a ranked opponent next. Jalen Turner picks up a TKO victory over Josh Koulibaly in round 2. Jake Matthews won rounds 1 and 2. Emil Mech took round 3, but in the end, it's a unanimous decision for Matthews, 29-28 on all the cards. Emil has lost 3 in a row. Song Kanaan put on an impressive striking display and KO'd Callan Potter 2-20 into the contest. He has 10 first round finishes. Kaikara France wins a unanimous decision over Tyson Nam. He has won 9 of his last 10 fights. Angela Hill picks up a unanimous decision victory over Loma Lukbumi. This was Hill's 6th fight in under a year, breaking a UFC record. Priscilla Cachoeira came out swinging early and caught Shauna Dobson with an uppercut and picks up the TKO victory 40 seconds into the fight. The next UFC event features Joe Benavidez getting his 3rd crack at the flyweight title. This time around he takes on Davison Figueiredo, and this is for the vacant flyweight strap. This time Benavidez is the slight favorite and could achieve his goal of becoming the champion at the age of 35 after 34 fights and 14 years in the sport. At LFA 82, Nate Richardson was KO'd by Jake Childers via slam. His head didn't hit the mat, but collided with his opponent's head. Gilbert Burns is listed as around a 2-1 favorite versus Damian Maia on March 14th. Burns is ranked number 12 and Maia is ranked number 5 at welterweight. So if those favorable odds for Burns do come true, he could be ranked in the top 5 with this victory in the co-main event in Brasilia. Cowboy Cerrone is contemplating getting back in the cage in March or April. He says there's no medical suspension that would deny him doing so. He was TKO'd by Conor McGregor on January 18th.